are back. Hello there, everybody. DJ Numa here with no one else. And welcome back to Dragon Ball Z League Season 7, Week 11. Let's just get it over with. It's the Lefties versus the Little Green Men in Hell. Yeah. Should be an interesting fight.
I'll show you what a true martial artist can do.
Feel the power of a Ginyu Force.
Hey.
Goldo.
So Tien versus Goldo should be interesting. Should definitely be interesting. Dunk. It's a really sad day because WrestleMania went 1-10. But you know what? All of their matches were really good overall, I gotta admit. What they could benefit from for the playoffs would be looking at the builds that were used last season, and definitely looking towards, looking towards the future. Looking towards next season. There's Dry Beam. 3, 4. 4 Tri Beams. Wow. That's the most I've seen since the Gohans took them all to the face. Very nice usage of your ultimate, Tien. Anyway. Goldo needs to tag. Hey! There you go. And in comes Lord Slug. And gets blinded immediately. Yay! Darkness Eye Beam. Lord Slug continuing to sweep the leg when he shouldn't be. See? Aw, Tien, why did you do that? You could have gone max and done another tri-beam set. There's Dodonre. Hey, look, a point and kill. 2 point and kills. Tien's at max. Will we see another Neo tri-beam? We see Slug's ultimate. I forget what his ultimate is. Oh, that's what it is. Bye, Tien! So, a bunch of bitch slaps. Wow. Slug, your ultimate sucks. And now would be the time to just use a normal tri-beam. Come on, Tien. That's Dodon Ray. That was a Dodon Ray. Not a tri-beam. Darkness Eye Beam. Wild sensed away. Alright, Tien. Get. Tien. What are you doing, buddy? Tien. And a finger beam. Misses. Alright, Tien doing a very nice last stand. Gotta be honest, did not expect him to last this long with less than a half bar of health. Really didn't. You gonna try beam? No? Not gonna do nothing. Alright. Bye, Tien. And in comes Gohan. With a super explosive wave. Very nice. Yeah, And Slug's at half health. So technically the Lefties are behind right now. Slug's transforming. That's actually kind of the worst thing you could do, because now Gohan's got bigger targets for every single one of his moves. Yep. Good job, Slug. Good job. Whee! You gonna do anything there, Slug? What are you doing, buddy? Come on. Full power from Gohan. And he just starts getting hit in the face with a Masenko. You're just gonna get swept in the face. And in comes PyCon. The man, the myth, the major league legend now. For the first time ever. And a Hyper Tornado. Gets punched out of it. Gohan showing him his place. Wow. Very nice. Ooh. Full power charge. Oh, missed. And PyCon is taking Gohan to town right now. Like, there's no way. There's just no way for him to really do anything. Damn, PyCon. He's telling him not to underestimate him. And Gohan's done. He's out. He's going Super Saiyan. Now tag. Now tag. Gohan, tag. Bye, Gohan. That was sad. And in comes Nerl. Kick his ass. Good job, Nerl. And a Hyper Tornado. Oh, wait, no, Thunder Flash. Ooh, 17,000 points of damage from PyCon. Full power energy wave. Into a burning chute. That was not a good idea, PyCon. And PyCon showing why he's been in the minor leagues all these years. And a Hyper Tornado hits Nail. I'm calling this here. Like, it's not even close to an even fight. There's still like two bars left on Goldo. PyCon's still in, Slug is still in, and Nail really has nothing that he can do against any of them. One more move from PyCon and Nail's done. If Nail brings out his ultimate, PyCon's done, but then he has to go. This is Mystic Flasher. It connects! Alright, now follow up on it, buddy. Nail. I said follow up. There you go. He kicked him in the nose. And down goes PyCon. And in comes Lord Slug. Darkness Eye Beam. If any of those connect, it's over for Nail. He could bring it back, though. Oh, he knows that he can't get hit by those. He's stalling. All right, now, come on. Darkness Eye Beam misses. He's trying to go in for melee, but he can't do that. He needs to super energy wave him. And I don't think he's gonna be able to keep up with Slug right now. Come on, Nail. Going max. Come on. Oh, man. And Slug's down. Now Nail only has to ultimate Goldo. If he ultimates Goldo, it's over. Psychic Rock Throw connects, and that's it. That's the match. Goldo taking the victory for Little Green Men. Wow. Wow. That was quite the ending. Anyway, we're on to our next match. We've got the Evolution of Evil versus the Red Ribbon Pencil Factory. I just picked up my DualShock 4 trying to hit X. Oops. And let's move. Alright. Hi, purple loser. Times two. No, that's a lie. 19. He's not very powerful. He's not powerful at all. And 19 on a full-on melee build this week. Ooh, very good job from 19 right off the bat. Utilizing what little power he had to straight up... Oh, he's getting suplexed. All right. And 19, showing why he was on Piccolo AI for the longest time. Because on Broly AI here, he's not doing much. Gotta be honest, I mean, other than that high speed clash, he's not really taking, Ginyu to, he's not really taking Ginyu out to, the pasture here. It's not even the right saying, Rich. Come on. Ah! He is, however, cackling maniacally at him. Come on. Oh. Fair enough. I mean, you know. Got an even fight. I don't think that Red Ribbon Pencil Factory is looking for an even fight here. I think that they're looking to annihilate Ginyu with as much health as possible and then deal with Super Evil Boo and Garlic Jr. as they come along. What 19 should be doing, however, is really just grabbing him, taking health and energy, and just saving up for Garlic Jr. and Evil Boo, because when they come in, they are so reliant on their energy. If he can grab them, if he can stay alive and grab them, then he basically cripples the entirety of the team. And Ginyu's their melee fighter. There you go, 19. And now the grabs start, and now he's pumping himself up. Full power energy wave to the face. I think the wall absorbed half of it. Ooh. And out goes Ginyu. And in comes Super Boo. Or Super Evil Boo. Now, what 19 needs to do is grab him. Grab him. If 19 grabs him, then he's fine. Oh. He's out. And in comes Mercenary Tao to take a Kamehameha to the face. And it's begun. Grand Style Assassin Strike screws out that Super Kamehameha. You tried to charge too long there, Boo. Should have done an instant Kamehameha. Oof. Very powerful. And Boo's already brought Tao down to 2 bars. Or down by 2 bars. Sorry. The original Dodonpa! Just remember, guys, Tao can't lose. Doesn't matter which Tao it is, whether it be Cyborg Tao or Mercenary Tao, he just can't lose. Very nice. Is Tao at max? I think Tao's at max. Tao's at max. Ultimate final plan! Connects!
Please forgive me.
Pencil! False courage. And the tower's still standing. Barely. He blocked it. That Kamehameha just got blocked, folks. The original Dodonpa takes out Boo. Very well done. Can he take out Ginyu? That is the question. Great style Assassin Strike blocked. Galaxy Dynamite. Ooh. Connects. And Tao is doing 10 times worse against Ginyu than 19 was. And a suplex. The original Dodonpa connects and he tags. And in comes General Blue, because he'll shoot you. Just remember that, folks. He'll shoot you. Oh. Whee. Come on, Rocket Engine Spark. Rocket Engine Spark. Please, do something. Rocket Engine Spark. Dodged. Sadly, that takes out all of his energy, and now he's just having his face shot in by Ginyu. This is the best Ginyu's done all season. Why is it against Pencil Factory? He'll shoot you! And so far, 19 is the one who's done the most damage to Ginyu, and that's barely any. Will we see a body change? That is the question. Oh, worst knockback in the game into a Galaxy Dynamite. Now would be the time for you to not do that, Ginyu. And in comes Garlic Sweep the Leg Jr. He'll shoot you! And then tell you that he's the worst while you smack him in the face. Come on. Come on, you could do it, Blue. And he tags! And in comes 19. This is, like, one of the most important things. 19 needs to grab Garlic Jr. It's never worked for you, dude. It's never worked, Garlic. You need to start grabbing. 19. You need to grab. Not pump up, you need to grab. You need to... 19. Alright, I'll just stay here while you do your thing. Like, you need to grab him, nut buddy. And Garlic Jr. sweeping the leg. And in comes Tao! And down goes Tao. We could, however, see the ultimate final plan again. Will we see the ultimate final plan? We'll see an original Dodonpa connect for 7,000 damage of max power. And a tag. And in comes Blue. Rocket Engine Spark, Blue. If you Rocket Engine Spark, you could, in theory, still win this. Kicked out of the high-speed rush into a sweep the leg, misses. Come on. Either skewer him or Rocket Engine Spark. I know it seems like I'm very biased towards this team, but I want to see them do good. Especially against this team. You know, the evolution of evil. Skewer! Connects! Pencil Factory mate! Whoa! What? And a tag? And in comes Tao. And down goes Tao. And in comes Blue. Come on, Rocket Engine Spark, Blue. Or you could just, you know, go and die. And he goes and dies. No, the power of garlic is the power to make your breath stink. And we are on to our last match of the season. Next week, we go to the playoffs. But first, we've got the Blue Man Group versus the Baldies, who had Piccolo sweep an entire team last week. Yeah. Yeah. It happened. All right.
Hey, why don't you be my opponent? Understood.
This should be interesting. And somebody got the first attack. It was Freeza Soldier. And Freeza Soldier putting the hurt onto... I can't even say that. One hand! Connected! Huh. Cool. Well done, Freeza Soldier. You've done more than you've done the rest of the season combined. Other than killing Yajirobe for a win. That was absolutely hilarious. Kick. Full power charge. He's got that? I already had that. And not doing anything. Oof. One hand. To the face of Dodoria. Dodoria. And Frieza's soldier taking it to Dodoria. I'm liking it. Actually says a lot about Dodoria. Oof. And doing very nice melee damage, honestly. Gotta say. He's doing very, very nice melee damage, Frieza's soldier is. I think that the Dendes that he's got on is also helping. If he takes down half of Dodoria, I'll be proud of him. And I think that's all anyone could ask, really, is for him to take down Dodoria before Piccolo comes in and absolutely annihilates everything that he holds near and dear. Two hands! Connects for 3,000 damage. Look at the damage. And he tags! And in comes Kai with energies last. Which misses. Worth noting, guys. Piccolo hasn't even hit the field yet. And Supreme Kai is on a charge build. Blink. Missed. Taking the first damage of the game with Dodoria behind him. Going to max. He's at max power. We can see Garrett's juice. Which is just a more powerful energy's last. That's free energy's last. You gonna use your ultimate, Kai? You gonna do anything? No, you're gonna just melee power him. And a crazy rush gets knocked out of it. Still has an impressive charge rate, even underwater. Tried to get the shockwave off, he failed. And Dodoria with the tankiest build of all tankiness. Chemico! Supreme Kai doing fairly well against Dodoria, gotta be honest. A lot better than, what's his name? Freeza Soldier was doing against basically everyone. Although, those energies lasts that you keep missing, those are kinda terrible. And, you gonna do anything? What was that, Supreme Kai? What are you? Dunk. Alright, energy's last. This will get rid of Dodoria. Dodoria's down, and in comes Piccolo. The King of Kings. Alright. Ooh. After image strike from Kai, special beam cannon dodged, and he just threw a brick at him. And if Piccolo can avoid, or if Kai can avoid killing Piccolo, then we should be fine here. Crazy Rush. Transforms early. And Supreme Kai taking Piccolo down a notch. I don't know if Sengai's going to be able to keep up with him, though, if she has to come in. Not letting him get anything off. Crazy Combination connects. And Supreme Kai showing Piccolo why you don't get cocky after you annihilate an entire team. Wow. Doesn't matter if Style is strong. If you got Style is strong on, what matters is if you can use that max power, and Piccolo is not being allowed to use any power by Supreme Kai. Supreme Kai is just in his face the entire time, which is what you need to do to beat Piccolo. Sadly. But at the same time, Piccolo's got such good melee that it doesn't even matter. False Courage going up. And he's charging. Don't let him charge, Kai. Alright, he's at max. And down goes... Oh, Shingetsukushin. Wild Sensed, dodged. And Special Beam Cannon stopped. And he tags. Very well done, Supreme Kai. In comes Frieza's Soldier. The cannon fodder for all of us. One hand. Missed. Come on. If Frieza's Soldier takes down Piccolo, then Piccolo has the right to be embarrassed. Especially after two hands! Misses. And... You're gonna take him out, Soldier? And he tags! And here comes Krillin for the first time in 2 weeks! Forgot he was even in the match. Frieza Soldier needs to tag out. Or Krillin could expanding energy wave and kill him. You just got killed with the worst move in the game. Alright, in comes Supreme Kai again. Full power energy wave, Krillin takes it. Kai didn't have enough time to regain any health. And Krillin is not letting him use any of it. He can't even tag out right now into Zangaya. She's not ready. And down goes Supreme Kai. In comes Zangaya. Full power. We could see a Sky Zapper. After destructiveness to the face. Solar Flare. She has no idea where he is. Oh, hey. There he is. The question is, though, will we see Sky Zap? Zangaya. Sky Zapper! Connects! Very nice usage of it. And Krillin is down 18,000 more health. Holy shit. And again with the Solar Flare. And another Expanding Energy Wave. Connects somehow for 9,000 points of damage from Krillin. Zangaya can still do this. She just needs to take out Krillin. You just need to take down Krillin. Even a trap shooter would kill him now, girl. But she's saving for Piccolo, who's coming with Savior and Style of the Strong. You need to take down Piccolo, Zhang. Shoot Blaster. Wild Sense. Special Beam Cannons. Dodged. And if she can take him down... Oh, no. Zhangaya. Just trap shooter him. At this point, you... Yep. And it's decided... And I do believe, if the Lefties lost, which they may have, that we may have a new league leader going into the playoffs here, folks, with the Baldies. Anyway, that's it for this week. We'll see you next week with the wild card division match. I'm DJ Numa, and this has been the Dragon Ball Z League Minor League Season 7. Toodaloo!